Welcome to Signal and System lecture series. Here in this session, I'll be explaining convolution by image method and this method that we need to utilize when two signals are given in terms of waveform. So this is very interesting method. Now see, before I explain you this method, first we need to see these two signals are given x of t, and that is e to the power minus 3t into u of t, means this signal is starting from 0 and it is going towards infinity. And if you see y of t, so that signal is step signal which is starting from 2. So if I say my convolution, so that is z of t, and if that signal z of t, if I say this is what, instead of y of t, if I say this is h of t, so z of t, that has to be x of t convolution with h of t. Now if you do this with integration, we have formula even, but we don't need to calculate that by formula as this is given in terms of waveform. So I'll explain how we can have that by using waveform step by step. Now see, if you observe what are the limits of z of t, then limits of z of t, I have already explained that, that will be sum of lower limit less than t less than sum of upper limit. Now if you calculate sum of lower limit, so for this it is 0 and for this it is 2, so 0 plus 2 less than t less than sum of upper limit, over here it is infinite, and over here even it is, for this signal is even it is infinite, so infinite plus infinite. So limit of z of t, that is in between 2 to infinite. So whatever signal that we are plotting with convolution, so resultant limit is varying from 2 to infinite. So it must be clear to all. Now see, I'll explain how to do this convolution step by step. So first step, that is to represent this given signal in terms of 2. So I'll be representing this signal in terms of 2. So instead of x of t, now I will have to make it in terms of x of 2. So x of 2, if I place, so it will start from here, right? And you'll be finding this is what, x of 2, so it has to be e to the power minus 3 to u of 2, and h of 2, so h of t is this, so h of 2, that is even same, but we need to replace that in terms of 2. So magnitude is 1 and over here time is starting from 2. Now see, then after we need to fold one signal and shift it. So here I see this h of 2 is easier to get fold and we can easily shift it. So I'll be shifting, I'll be folding this h of 2 and then I'll shift it. So if I fold h of 2 with h of minus 2, so now see, signal is starting from 2, so now this signal will start from minus 2, and signal is going towards positive infinity, so this signal now after image of it, it will get go towards minus infinite. So this is what folding of h of 2, so that is h of minus 2, magnitude will be remain 1. Now see, there are two things which is possible. Now if you shift this h of 2 by h of t minus 2, so what will happen is like this signal that will get shifted in this direction, in this direction by t time period. We will be shifting this signal by t time period in this direction. So if I shift this signal with h of t minus 2, so you'll be finding now after t time period, if it is happening here, right, here there is minus 2, so this has to be t minus 2. Now here there are two cases that one can consider. One case is, we will be plotting this only h of t minus 2. But in one case, if I say t minus this t, if it is greater than 2, if this t that is greater than 2, so in that case, this shifting that will go towards this side, right, with respect to 0. So in case of t is greater than 2, you'll be finding it is happening somewhere here, where still this is what, t minus 2. And if you observe h of t minus 2 with second case where t is less than 2, so in that case you'll be observing this signal will remain here, where this is what, t minus 2. So this will be going to happen. Now what is that which we need to do? So we need to multiply signal, which is x of t. Now x of t is not shifted one. So if you multiply x of t, see this, if you multiply x of t, which is starting from 1 and it is going towards infinity, and that is what, e to the power minus 3 tau into u of tau. So if you multiply these two signal over here, this signal is there, and in this direction this signal is nothing. So resultant of multiplication of these two signal, that has to be 0. So if I say convolution, which is what, resultant of x of 2 and h of 2, convolution of these two multiplication, so that will be 0. So this multiplication for this case, t less than 2, convolution, that is equals to 0. Now if you shift this t greater than 2, so in that case you'll be finding some answer will come as this signal, that is e to the power minus 3 tau u of tau. So now you will be finding some multiplication as this signal is getting inside of that e to the power minus 3 tau u of tau. So this resultant multiplication, so that has to be e to the power minus 3 tau, and you are just multiplying unit magnitude, so u of tau, and it should get shifted greater than 2 time period, so t minus 2. So that is what, a multiplication which will happen in this multiplication as t is greater than 2. So if you see resultant of convolution, you will have to plot it in this way. It will be this, where this magnitude is 1, and this is what, having time period starts from 2, e to the power minus 3 tau u of t minus 2. So that will be the resultant signal. I hope that you have understood this. Like, see, one thing that we need to focus here first is just plot that signal with respect to tau. Fold one signal here. I see u h of tau is easier to get fold, so I have folded it over here. Now if you shift it with t amount, then it will get shifted by t amount. It was there earlier with minus 2, but if you shift it by t amount, so that has to be t minus 2. Now it depends what is the position of this signal for value of t. If t is greater than 2, so this signal that will cross this 0 time reference. So if I consider t is greater than 2, this signal will get shifted inside of that period where you find x of t is there, right? And if you consider t is less than 2, in that case it is staying in this direction. So if you multiply these two signals, you will be finding this is 0. So convolution for t less than 2, that will be always 0. Now what happens for t greater than 2? So for t greater than 2, multiplication with 1 will be this signal only. So multiplication, so see e to the power minus 3 tau. So e to the power minus 3 tau is happening. But see, multiplication with 1 is happening, but for the case of t greater than 2, so you'll have to have u of t minus 2 here instead of u of t. The reason is for t less than 2, it is not happening. So you will be observing resultant is actually this, which is e to the power minus 3 to u of t minus 2. So I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any query regarding this, please give me your suggestions, and based on that, in future I'll make videos which will be solving your queries. Thank you so much for watching this video.